What is the consequence of subclinical disease? Broiler flocks with chicken anemia fighters antibodies have shown a decreased profit in Northern Ireland, where they have a very good system to measure the productivity and profits of broiler production. Now, to be honest about this, other groups could not repeat those studies that were done by McNulty and his co-workers in Northern Ireland. And some of those studies actually did not show an effect. However, it is well accepted that infection with chicken anemia virus increases the susceptibility to other diseases, such as Merrick's disease, infectious bronchitis, the different coccidiosis infections, etc., etc. Moreover, infection with chicken anemia virus can also cause suboptimal responses to the different vaccinations that you give to the chickens. So it may then lead to suboptimal protection and hence disease against pathogens that otherwise would be well controlled by vaccination. How prevalent is chicken anemia virus in the broiler industry? And there is a recent paper that came just out in Avian Diseases in 2014 that was done in Ontario. The group there examined over 230 flocks at processing time, which is around 38 days of age in Ontario, Canada, and they looked for several viruses, including chicken anemia virus. And I only will deal with chicken anemia virus. They differentiated the infection status in several groups, actually 12 total, and the first group was PCR positive and ELISA titers of over 8,660, and they considered those birds obviously positive, but none of the flocks had reached that situation. Groups 2 to 4 consisted out of PCR positive birds with ELISA titers ranging from 1,000 to 8,660 in their system, and 44% of those flocks, 44% of the flocks had this characteristic. Then they had two groups that were PCR positive and ELISA with a titer of less than 1,000. Obviously, the infection was going on at that time, and they found 11% of the flocks positive in category 5 to 6. Then the final positive groups, 7 to 10, were PCR negative, but there was evidence of an ELISA titer between 1,000 to over 8,660, and 22% of those of the flocks fell into this group. So in total of 77% of the birds, of the flocks were positive for exposure to chicken anemia virus, and only 23% of the flocks at processing time were still negative for chicken anemia virus.